let's take you to the beach in Ground Truth with meteorologist Mike Seidel. He's at Daytona Beach. Mike, just kind of a windy, raw, sand-in-your-face kind of day.
Yeah, the nitty-gritty. I can taste the sand. Look at it blowing down the beach here at Daytona. This is a north wind, and it's coming right down the coast. We've got the high to the north, and that channeling effect with weak low pressure to the south. Boy, it is just gusty out here, 20 to 25 miles an hour, gusting up to 40. Now, the tide is going out. Low tide about 8 o'clock tonight. Let me show you where high tide was this morning. About 2 a.m. this morning, I looked out, and this is where high tide was. High tide earlier this afternoon went almost up to the boardwalk. In fact, in some places here where we are north of the pier, it did hit the boardwalk. Not a whole lot of beach erosion. We were concerned about some beach erosion, but it's all about the wind and the rip currents. And although the wind is going to die down later this evening, tomorrow we still have surf and rip current issues. And obey the lifeguards. The lifeguards didn't even come out here today. A few people went into the water, saw a couple surfers. This is not a great surfing environment. Radar shows you where the rain is, where it's been most of the day to the south of us. We had some showers earlier, but where we had the golf ball size hail, the severe weather, Melbourne, Indian Atlantic, Satellite Beach had golf ball size hail, Cocoa Beach. Now we've got that marine warning from Cape Canaveral down to Jupiter, primarily along and offshore for the boaters, marine interest, and the concern, again, strong wind gust, over 34 knots, that's over 39 miles an hour, and water spouts, not out of the question. So the winds die down a little bit overnight. By tomorrow morning, running about 15 miles an hour. Sun comes back out tomorrow. Nice day here, a little cooler than average. Average high here in Daytona now 76. We'll be at 72, but you'll be able to get on the beach. I wouldn't go venture too far out in the water. Heed the lifeguards and the red flag warnings, which are up today. And then as we roll towards the end of the week, in the weekend, we're going to head back well into the 70s. Right now on Sunday, Mike, we're talking temperatures up around 80, 81 degrees. But look at the sand here. Wow.
Yeah.
You don't often see that here in Florida in March. It's more of a pre-hurricane tropical storm setup when you have winds this strong blowing the sand before the rain hits.
You know, when there's only one person on the beach and it's a Weather Channel meteorologist, it's not a good weather day, right? Usually the beaches in Florida are packed this time. You are literally got the beach all to yourself, Mike, and I think there's a we know the reason why, that's for sure. Mike, thanks so much. We're going to get more from Mike throughout the show tonight. Bye.